back in the city, so I need to take another road now. Here we go, the Gum station. Actually, this is not the main road to Siliguri. It's additional road. It was recommended for me from the owners of the guest house I slept last night. They said that this road is much better and the traffic is much less. So let's see. I already started thinking that the fog is like something necessary here all the time, part of the town. See now, it's going like a big curtain from that direction. Look at now what it became, really invisible. Like a horror movie. Riding conditions from Darjeeling to Siliguri. Very beautiful road, but so foggy, guys. Look at now. Actually, cannot see on more than 30-40 meters in front of me. I am at the moment on around 2000 meters, which is 6000 feet. So I hope when I get down, it will be clear. I'm riding with 30-40 kilometers per hour. And I need to open my visor because otherwise I see nothing. I have a pin lock, but I already said in one of the videos, the pin lock supposed to be isolated completely, so it should be an air gap between the pin lock and your visor, but it's not always exactly 100% isolated, and when you use it for a long time, especially on the dust environment, some dust go in, and this is exactly the case with my visor now. Some dust stuck between the pin lock and the visor, and it makes the things even worse, especially during the night when the light actually reflects on the small pieces of dust, or on riding condition like that on fog when you need a clear visibility. So pin lock is a very useful gadget, very nice to have it, so because you don't have fog on your visor. But what I notice with my experience, they usually last about a year, and after a year they are not the same already. Start to get some dust and some fog on the edges. So this is what it's about. Okay, so it's better here now. Let's see. All right. It is 1 p.m. but because of the fog, I have the impression that it's later in the evening. It's so deep, man. Alright, another one busy place. Siliguri 69, alright, good. Man, why they should be... It's nice when it's clean. Alright, it was without fog for 10 minutes. Oh, now clean again and fog again. See again. And some people ride without even lights. Why? I don't know. Great riding road. Siliguri? So far, so good. I cannot say that I'm some kind of riding expert, especially on the twisty roads, but for me, the Himalaya is doing just great. Just great. Look at these guys. Look at how they're traveling. Man, this is a risky job. Oh, I can't stop laughing in this country. I cannot stop laughing, honestly. Let me see where I can overtake it. If I can, of course. Ah, it's another few. Inside. All right. Just wait a couple of seconds to leave this village, so I guess when I leave it there will be some twisty roads so I can enjoy it. Alright. So my opinion is that it's doing absolutely great. The brakes are good enough for the power and for the speed it can deliver, because some people said, oh, terrible brakes. Yeah, if you're coming from sport bike, you have a double disc in front, you have such a power and you need brakes, but this bike is only 25 horsepower, so such a brakes are not really necessary, because you cannot really have that speed, and it's not that heavy. It is only 180 kilograms, something like that. Of course, if you have a passenger, it's going to be a different story, but I don't think that many people will take this bike to ride it with passenger, because it has not enough power. Alright. But the twist is, my opinion, it just handled it absolutely brilliant. And these tires, very cheap Indian tires, brand is Seat. Man, they may be cheap, maybe whatever, but so far I haven't got even a simple moment when the tires were not good. Even when I have to climb a Rotang pass, which is absolutely terrible winter condition and a lot of mud, these tires just brought me to the top without any problems, without any stops, without any doubts. And now on dry roads, they never slip, they never move, they are like stuck to the asphalt. Going back to the twisty roads, I think that this bike is handling absolutely brilliant any kind of roads. So why shouldn't handling the twisties as well? It's more depending really from your riding style. You have to change more gears, as I do, or this is my riding style. I prefer to be on low gear when I'm taking turns like this, instead of tilting too much and trusting so well that I'm gonna make it. And also because I don't know this road, I have to be ready for everything. But if you know the road, if you know the conditions, and if you know that the traffic is not a problem, then you can really make a lot with this bike. So I always believe that everything is coming from the person behind the handlebar, not exactly from the bike. So any bike in the right person could be great bike, could be used for anything, for twisty roads, for racing, for adventure riding, for long trips, whatever. It really depends from you. All of these guys is T. Exactly the same as the tea gardens in Darjeeling. Maybe these gardens are also go to the same factory, because they said they've got 87 different plants. So, I don't know, look at this. It's like a sea of this tea everywhere on the hills. Oh man, look at this. Such a beautiful area to ride. There are many crossroads on that route. So every time when I go to another section, there is no sign. So every time I'm stopping and asking people, just to be sure that I'm on the right direction. Transportation, huh? What do you think? These guys, this road is just brilliant. Look at this jungle, guys. Real, real jungle. The first straight road I had from 2 hours. Just for 1 minute. So since I came here, the temperature rise extremely, so I think it's around 25 degrees now. From 10 was on the top, here is 25. See what the kids got, this one. At the end of every village is one things like this, and all the kids are there waiting for their turns to play. Have a look now, this, the trees and the palm trees, exactly like tropical jungle. So I set the GPS to find the hotel. My friend Sergei should be there. He's already there actually. He sent me the location just 2 minutes ago. So it said 20 more minutes. Good. Monkeys here on the left side. This is some kind of park. And look at this. I like this moment. I need to make a picture. Nice, huh?